Research in the metaphysical field has shown the fact that man is as he thinks, that he becomes what he thinks, and that what he thinks in the present decides what he is to become in the future. And that since he may change his thought for the better, he may therefore completely change himself along any line. However, the majority who try to apply this law don't succeed to a great degree. The reason being that rather than working entirely upon the principle that man is as he thinks, they proceed in the belief that man is what he thinks he is. At first glance, there might seem to be no difference between the principle that man is as he thinks and the belief that man is as he thinks he is. But close study uncovers the fact that the latter is absolutely untrue. Man isn't what he thinks he is. As personality, mentality, and character are not determined by personal opinions. It's the thought of the heart that makes the personal man what he is, and not by what he may think of himself in the field of mere personal opinion. It's subjective thought that makes you what you are. But to think that you are thus or so won't necessarily make you thus or so. To produce subjective thought, you must act directly upon the subconscious. But it is not possible to impress the subconscious while you are forming feelings about your own personal self. A mere statement about yourself won't affect any change in the subconscious. And so long as the subconscious stays unaltered, you'll stay unchanged. While you are thinking simply about your external or personal self, you are acting upon the objective. But to alter yourself, you must act upon the subjective. You might think that you are well, but you will not secure health till you think thoughts that produce health. You might persistently affirm that you are well, but so long as you live in discord, confusion, worry, concern, and other wrong frames of mind, you will be sick. It is not what we say in our thoughts, but what we give our thoughts that decides results. To produce health, thought itself must be healthful and wholesome. It has to contain the quality of health and the very life of health. This, however, is not possible unless the mind is conscious of health at the time when such thought is being produced. To merely think that you are well won't teach the mind to understand the laws of life and health, nor will that thinking place you in harmony with those laws. You might believe that your mind is brilliant and might undertake most difficult tasks in the belief that you are equal to the occasion. But the question is if your conception of brilliancy is great or small. If your conception of brilliancy is little, you might be right to that degree in thinking you are brilliant. That is, you might be brilliant as far as your understanding of brilliancy goes. Whether that's sufficient to carry out the task or not, that's before you, is a different question. Your opinion of your mental capacity might be great, but if your idea of intelligence is primitive, your intelligence producing thought will also be primitive. Don't call yourself brilliant at any time, or don't consider yourself as lacking in brilliancy. Merely fix the mental eye on absolute brilliancy and desire with all the power of the mind and soul to go on into the higher steps of that brilliancy. Man is the result not of beliefs or opinions, but of quality of all the mental actions that are at work throughout the whole mind. Man is as he thinks in each thought, and not what he thinks he is in one or more isolated parts of his personal self. Now you might think that you are good, but your principle of goodness may be wrong. You are only good as the sum of all your good thoughts, and these may be increased in number indefinitely by training the mind to constantly grow in the consciousness of absolute goodness. To grow in the consciousness of goodness, keep the mental eye on the greatest conception of absolute goodness. What you think about yourself is always objective thought, and mere objective thought is powerless to alter anything in your nature. To alter yourself, you must go to the depth of mind where the causes of your personal condition exist. But your mind won't enter the depth of within so long as your thought is on the surface, and your thought will be on the surface so long as you are thinking exclusively about your personal self. The secret, therefore, isn't to form opinions about yourself or to consider yourself as being thus or so, but to form bigger conceptions of principles and qualities. Enter the richness of real life and you'll think richer thoughts. Forget the limits, the weaknesses and defects of your personal self, as well as your surface opinions of yourself, and seek and enter mentally into the grandness, the brilliance of all things. Seek to gain a larger understanding of the majesty of all life.